Welcome, Tylah&Co. Today I'm here with
Anna at Ahnasimone on YouTube, so make sure y'all subscribe to my channel.
On to a more positive note, friendship green flags.
Okay. Oh, I think a friendship green flag is someone that I'm not a friend that you have to talk to every day. If you really know me, all my friends know this.
She's like, I am the green flag.
Yeah, like I'm the flag. So I just feel like if you know like when to hit me up, when we should link, you know, because y'all have like a lot of stuff going on. All my friends have a lot going on. And I love that about my friends. Everyone's so driven. They're in a relationship. They job, school, whatever it may be, a hobby, a brand, whatever it may be. So I feel like there's a time and place for everything. So I think it's important to know when's a good time to link with your friends. And then I'm not a friend you gotta text every day. So, you know, a friend that can communicate very well, I think that's important. Not overdoing it. You don't gotta FaceTime me every day. We don't have to be texting every day. I don't even text my mom every 5 minutes. So I really don't wanna text y'all every 5 minutes. I think that's a green flag. I love a friend I can travel with. I think that's so fun. Like, one of my, was that like a love language to travel? I don't know. But one thing I like to do, I like to travel. So if my friends are there when we're trying to travel, celebrate a birthday, I'm big on birthdays.
I have yet to go on one of the trips.
Yeah. Next year. But anyway, I'm big on my friends who are down to just do anything too. Like, if you're just a down friend, like no matter what the situation is, no matter if it's like a little, someone's hosting a kickback, a housewarming, a dinner, a brunch. If you're just there when I need you to be, you're a good friend in my book.
Yeah, definitely a friend that's adaptable. You can put them in any room with you. Mm-hmm. You can put them in any group with you, and they're good people. They're having a good time. They can have a good time. Like, I want my friendships to be about like having fun, making memories, and literally just laughing. And I think it's a green flag with someone that can go with the flow and make the best out of any moment because they're there with you. They're up for anything. I do like friends that give advice and know when to give advice. Because sometimes you just want to vent, and sometimes you need advice. And just a friend that can listen, if you need them to listen, and to let you know what it really is, and how you should move, or tell you about yourself. I think that is a good quality, good traits for someone to be straight up and honest. Like, being honest is always going to be a green flag to me. So I think that's great in friendship. Humor. You have to be able to be too serious.
You know, like, you're gonna lose.
Like give and take. Like, we could go back and forth, have fun with it. Like, nobody's gonna take anything any kind of way, but make a joke. Laugh a little. I don't wanna just be sitting around like sad.
Yeah.
Or talking about somebody.
Like, yeah.
Let's do something.
Yeah. It's definitely important to have friends. Also, a green flag is like to talk, someone you can talk to about your goals and like what you're trying to get to in life. And, where you see yourself 10 years down the line. Like, I think it's important to have those serious talks with your friends as well. And someone that you know won't, you know, take it the wrong way. So I just think,
that's important. Yeah. Let's see. What is another green flag?
Being real. Being trustworthy.
Yeah, and trustworthy.
You gotta be a trustworthy friend. I don't wanna hear my business. I told you and it's down the street, you know. So let's keep it in the
line.
Let's just keep it.
And also, if someone's talking about me, I do think that I have the friends that if I'm not in the room, they're gonna uphold who I am, who they know I am. And if someone says anything different, they're going to say something or remind them of who I actually am if I'm not there. So I think I'm very lucky with the friends I do have. And I've had the friends I do have for a long time. So when you have all those green flags, like, you're going to keep that friend, and there's really nothing that you can't communicate to them to where you can't get over it. Yeah. So if that friend is giving that same effort that you are, showing that same love to you, in the same room, in another room, then And that also kind of leads into the next question. That's like, how do you maintain a long friendship?
So we've been friends. We've all been friends for over a decade now. I don't even know exactly how long.
Since sixth grade. I don't even know what year it is.
I don't know how long it is. A long time. But I think the key to maintaining a long friendship and healthy friendship at that is just, first of all, I think it's important to always wish the best for your friends, no matter what they're doing, and supporting them, no matter if it's something you agree with or you don't. You know, you just need to be like their right hand. Like, I'm not here to judge my friends. I'm not here to, you know, speak down on you, because we're all human, we're all learning, and I think it's just important to just be a listening ear sometimes. Sometimes it's good to just not talk, you know, just sit back and listen. Don't get me wrong, I like to talk, I like to get my opinion. But there's a time and place for everything.
Yeah.
And I think it's important in a friendship to just know that, like, I'm gonna hold you down regardless whatever you're going through, and just knowing that, like, we just locked in. Like,
yeah.
It just is what it is. No questions asked. You know, and friends know right from wrong. So if you think it's some funny stuff going on with your friend,
you know,
some funny stuff going on with your friend.
Yeah.
So, you know, read the room. Read the room.
Okay. I think another part of, like, having a long-term friendship is, like, just extending yourself. Like, if they're doing anything, what can I do to help? Where do you need me to be right now? Like, just asking and being open to them. And kind of like you said earlier, everyone is in different places of their life right now. We're in our 20s, so everyone is really in different places. And it's important to understand that, and having a good understanding of where they are. So, like, if they don't respond right away, or if they aren't, like, the same, giving them that little space, be able to give your friends space.
Grace
is definitely, like, a big one. Giving them grace and understanding, okay, I may not be going through what they're going through, but I understand that you may just need that time. We'll talk about it when we talk about it, and when they come to you to talk about it, understand, and don't hold that grudge. If you feel like I called you and you didn't pick up, and we haven't hung out in a month, like, also doing things that aren't, like, phasing out of, like, college and stuff. You don't have to go and party all the time. You can, like, maybe, like, read a book together. Read the same book. Talk about that same book.
Go work out together.
Yeah, go work out together.
It's like everyone's hobbies are different. And, like, for me, like, I like to work out. So, like, I want my friends, let's go to, like, you know, some Pilates. Let's do something active. Let's go to a coffee shop. You got some work to handle. You want to get together on a Sunday to do that before the work week. Like, you just have to know, like, what your friends are focused on. And I think that it's important to, you gotta really know your friends to know what they need out of you, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know, everyone has different hobbies and goals, but if you wanna be a good friend, you gotta have to, like, adapt to what makes them happy.
Yeah.
It's not always about you. Like, it's just not. It can strictly be an activity. An activity costs $0.
Okay? Yeah, you can literally just watch the same show.
Yeah.
Have a movie night.
Movie night.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, movie night. Yeah. How do you know the difference between a friend and an associate?
I think a friend is someone you confide in. A friend is someone you give that effort to. Like I just said, what you want to do, I'm interested in. I want to help. I want to, you know, reach out and show my support in any kind of way. An associate is someone that when I see you, I see you. That's literally it. That's like a kid.
When we link, we link.
Yeah, when I see you, I see you. If
you, I wish the best for you, but
no bad blood, but we just are not like that, you know. So I think it's just simple. We're just, if I see you, all smiles. If I will follow you on Instagram, I will follow you on all socials, and we are cool. You aren't close to me, and I'm not gonna tell you my secrets, so that's just it. Nothing bad. Mm-hmm. That nothing wrong with being an associate. What do you think?
I think a friend and associate, I would definitely say along the lines as well. I think you have to really pick carefully who you consider a friend and who you consider an associate. Not everyone wishes well for you, and you want to keep good people in your circle. Like I said earlier, I'm big on energy, so if I feel like the energy is not real truthful, you want the best for me just as much as I want the best for you, then we're gonna just keep it, you know, surface level. And you also can't tell everybody everything. So an associate, you're gonna keep it on a kiki level. But a friend, you're gonna really confide and you're gonna trust them. You're gonna, you know, go through the good and bad with them. So yeah, I wouldn't say it's negative at all.
Yeah.
But I'm also not, I have a lot of different friend groups as well. But I'm also not someone that has 80,000 people in my business. You know, if you know me, you know me. And if you don't, it's probably a reason you don't know.
Yeah.
You know, and it's no shade, but you gotta keep it close-knit. You know, you start talking too much and stuff goes left.
Yeah, and then your business is just entertaining. You're entertaining everybody at this point.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also I feel like piggybacking off of that, I don't need that many close friends. Like, the older I've gotten, not like I'm super old, I'm 25, so the older I get, the less I need a big, huge circle. Because in college, you know, I'm meeting all these people.
You're friends with everybody.
Yeah, in high school, and like, all this is like, you're around a bunch of people. And so living and learning, I just realized some of my people are like my people. They understand me, they understand what I need, how I am. And I can trust them. And I think that might just be the cutoff of an acquaintance. Like, you have fun with me. My friends might go through it with me. Or might, and I really have to have some sit downs. But yeah, nothing too crazy.
What? You know, like, act like a whore.
Okay. Okay, we can talk after this for sure. All right, you can go. Where are you here? Introduce the segment.
Okay, y'all. So the next topic is goals. So is a degree necessary to reach goals in life?
I think that a degree is necessary in certain fields. Personally, I went to school for psychology and I'm working in talent now. And I really do think that if I didn't have a degree of some sort, I wouldn't have gotten my job. So like, it's kind of unfair that you just need the paper. Like, you sometimes just need the paper to knock yourself up in the totem pole. But there's some things and some people. Like, one of my childhood friends owned a bunch of jewelry stores. Like, I'm talking very wealthy, great people. Dad never went to college. He just put in the work. So a lot of it is putting in the work to get to where you're going. And if you're really committed and you can put that time in. I mean, YouTube University. You can learn a lot from YouTube. You can learn a lot from the internet. So sometimes I will say yes. You can, but if you want to break through some industries, you do just have to have that degree, sadly. So what do you
think? Yeah. I think it just kind of adds credibility, and I think it's something for you to fall back on, literally on like a rainy day. You just never know. I just feel like when you go to like an interview or something like that, it just adds like
that extra.
You know, like, you may be a great person. You know, but I don't know. It just comes down really to paper. I don't know. I think at the end of the day, now there is, you can definitely be successful without a degree. I will say that. I have plenty of friends who are very successful entrepreneurs doing what they need to do without that background. But I think on a rainy day, we just never know how like the economy is gonna go. So if it comes down to you need to have a degree, I would just rather have it. It's better to, my mom always say, it's better to have it than not need it, and need it and not have it. So.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good.
Have it and not need it than to need it and not have it.
Okay.
So that's, I mean, not anything.
Yeah, I'm grateful to have went to university. It's very beneficial. I'm still very interested in psychology, but once you get into the real world and you see, you're able to read the market a little better, and that just would have required more time and more school that I didn't think that was like worth it. I did try a little bit, but I think that I'm going to be able to get far and make the money that I want to make without getting that additional education that psychology would have had me do. And once you get there, once you break through that glass, you can move up. You just have to actually do your job and show people that you are of value. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so I do think that
it's important.
I think it's important.
And I think like it's also like who you know. I think the biggest thing in life is connections and networking and putting your face in rooms that like you never thought you'd be able to get into. So, you know, going to those extra events, like a lot of my friends recently just went to the Afrotech. That was based in Austin, Texas, and just a lot of big tech companies went out there. You just never know where your name can end up. So put yourself in places that like you see yourself going further in. So don't be afraid to take a risk.
Yeah.
You just never know. If you want to be an entrepreneur, I don't really know if I would say like...
Oh, yeah. You've been an entrepreneur. So like,
So I could kind of speak on to like, you don't have to have that background experience. That's where I kind of get into like that networking and like knowing people and being open to new experiences and stuff like that. But I will say when it comes to like the corporate world, my degree is in background of like business marketing, so I've been able to meet people in my company now who kind of have like marketing experience and like are directors and VPs and things very highly within the company. And I think it's just cool to kind of learn their background. Like, if you want to follow in their footsteps, what do you have to do to get to the next step? No matter what you're trying to do, what do you have to do to get to the next step? So you're trying to get 7,000 subscribers, what do you have to do to get to the next step? You know, like, you just have to kind of have like a mindset and know that you're capable of doing so, and you'll be able to get there. Like, you can do whatever you want to do. That's how I feel.
It takes time.
And time. Yeah. Patience.
It takes time. So,
and don't rush the process, okay? Don't rush the process.
So, we're about to be in a recession.
Okay? So, get it together, y'all.
Lock in for you tweak out. Okay. So, then we have YouTube goals. What are your YouTube goals?
YouTube goes. So I've been on YouTube for like 3.5 years now, and my channel started off as a couples channel. That's what I was known as. And I think it's just kind of about like finding your niche and like, you know, what you want to do. But speaking further into that, like, my goals are, I don't want to reach a certain number, because to me it's like you could have 100,000 subscribers and only maybe 10% of them really are tuned in supporting you and following your journey and stuff like that. So I think the most important thing about like my goals I have is just to continue to be relatable. I don't want to post content that's not me. I want to post content that's real. If I act the same way to my friend right here, I want to act the same way to y'all on this camera. You know, I don't want anyone to say, that's not how she acts, she didn't do that. Like, I just want to be real. So goal for me is to continue just to be real and just being true to who I am. I don't have a certain number. I don't have a certain dollar amount I'm trying to reach. And I think that's key about YouTube. When you start looking at YouTube as
like a job,
a dollar amount, right, or a job, it's not going to be fun. Like, YouTube is supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be a hobby. It's supposed to be enjoyable. It's supposed to be just every day.
Like, entertainment, like, just for fun. Like, nothing too serious.
Nothing too serious. Because the minute you start taking, no matter if that's your job too, the minute you start taking it too serious, it's not going to be fun. So, and life too short. So, make sure y'all just enjoy everything y'all are doing to the fullest. And that's my goal. Be relatable.
That's a good one. I feel my goal is, you know, I'm new to YouTube. I have been in February. I think it'll be a year for me. So, I'm coming right up on a year. So I'm still learning. I'm still trying to understand even like what my niche is. I think the word niche is like really scary for me, because I'm like, I do so much with my life. I travel. I do talks with my friends. I'm with my family, and I do so much stuff. So it's like, what should I do? And I'm like, I need to just do what I do.
That's like lifestyle.
Yeah,
that's
just like lifestyle. I think lifestyle is probably the category. But I want people to watch and care for what I have to say. So I want to build on being consistent on certain aspects. Like, if I'm going to be doing talks, then I'm going to do several talks. I want y'all to know me and want to come back and hear what I have to say, because I always used to look at YouTube and say, I don't like to watch YouTubers when I don't care what they are doing, what they have to say. Like, I want to know you. I want to know why I'm watching you. Like, who are you? Yeah, who are you? And why am I watching you? And that's so important to me. So I feel what I want to do moving into the next year is do more sit down talks, what I'm thinking, what I care about, and be more relatable. Like, literally just be more relatable and set the camera up, even if I feel like it may or may not translate, it's me. And that's just what I can offer. Mm-hmm. I will say consistency, and I always hear that when people are like, how do you get big on YouTube? Mm-hmm. Consistency. I want to have that. I did take a break. I haven't posted in like,
you haven't posted in a while. What's going on? And you was on every Wednesday.
Yeah, I was going every week. And I would maybe skip a week, but I was going every week for a long time. And then I just started getting too busy. I was moving around too much. So I took my time away, but, you know, clearly I'm back. I do think that I need to be around more people that do YouTube. Like, this is my only YouTube friend. So, and we just now, after how long we're doing a video, I feel like I need to be around more people that are in this,
that content creation bubble.
Yeah, yeah.
Of just, like, being creative. I think that's just, like, what it is. Like, this is just, like, a creative platform where you're able to showcase different aspects of your life. Just, like, just TikTok, Instagram. You know, just showcasing different aspects of your life. And it's really just about how you do it.
Yeah.
That's just what it is, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, next question. Let's see.
10-year goals?
Okay, we can do 10-year.
All right, we're going to just say 10-year goals in, like, general life, things like that.
Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
So in 10 years, I'm currently 24. I just turned 24 November 9th, Scorpio season. She's Scorpio.
Scorpio.
But in 10 years, I'll be 34.
Okay.
So at 34, I plan to be married. Definitely married. I want two boys.
Very specific.
Yeah, I know.
I hope that comes true for you.
It will. It's going to come true. Thank you, God. Two boys. I definitely want to travel more. I love to travel. If you know me, traveling is like it's just my thing. Like, you just feel different, you know, in a different space and seeing the world. And life is too short to not see the world. So if y'all can travel, and y'all have the ability to, make sure y'all travel. But definitely want to travel the world some more and just be financially where I want to be. Like, stability within my family. I want to be comfortable. But not too comfortable, because when you get too comfortable, you get stagnant. So you always got to have some room to grow. And that's really it. I just want to be happy, you know. I just want to be happy. Every day of my life, I want to be happy. Because I was telling Tylah earlier, you know, another 24 hours is not promised. So, super blessed to even be here today. So, thank you, God. But,
drink to that.
Amen. What are your 10-year goals?
My 10-year goals, plural. I want to definitely be married. And I want to have multiple streams of income. I don't want to be locked into my corporate job the way that I am. So I want to be getting my money from different places, different areas, and definitely want to travel. I do like to travel, so that's always in the cards for me. I would love to have kids.
How many do you want?
So I want to have... My max is 4.
4?
But, listen.
Christ.
I want to do it in pieces.
I hope some twins.
I want to do it in pieces because I want to have 2 kids first and then raise them a little bit and, like, take a break and then have 2 more kids. So I don't want to have, like, 4 young kids. So probably by the time I'm 25 now, by the time I'm 35, I want to have 2 kids. So, yeah, that's it. And as far as YouTube, I would love for YouTube to be one of those streams of income to where, like, I'm having fun making money doing what I like love to do, like just being me, taking the camera with me and doing that.
Next question is like, what are our 2023 goals? 2023 is in less than 30 days.
You need to drink more, cause look at me.
Girl. Anyway, 2023 is in less than 30 days, and
time for another bottle.
In 2023, some goals. Well, first of all, I'm big on not saying too much, okay? Because not everyone is praying. A lot of people praying on your downfall. So I think it's also important to keep your close-knit goals to yourself, okay? So, but overall, 2023, more prosperity, more blessings. Growing closer and closer to my friends and building my friendships to even higher levels. My friends right now, we locked in, okay? So I love y'all. But other than that, just like more prosperity, money, and good relationships, friendships, networking, getting to higher and higher levels, which I will accomplish. And living every day like it's your last.
Yeah.
I plan to live 2023 like that, so.
Let's drink to that.
Amen. Happy 2023. It's almost New Year's Eve. Oh my God.
My goals, I think those are all good goals. I'm definitely following behind those as well. I really want to move forward in my relationship. I feel like that's like the number one thing in my life right now. I really would like to see my career grow. I'm constantly wanting to establish myself, and I don't want to be stagnant in any area. Definitely not monetarily. So I want to move a notch up and have a lot of good, meaningful experiences. Like, having good times, choosing
with good people. Okay.
Literally. Yeah. With good people. Having good times, good experiences, enjoying myself, and taking care of what I need to take care of. And that's it. Yay. So I hope y'all learned something, or, you know, connected to something that we talked about today. If you have any comments or how you feel, like, please put your answers to any of the questions that we had today in the comments, and just let us know how you feel about today and what we talked about, and join us for another Girls Talk.
Yes.
Cheers.
We gotta take another jet. Go.
Okay, another shot.
It doesn't taste bad. I don't know. I just feel like you're playing.
I could taste it after it's gone.
It actually tastes good to me.